first kind of lid, or I don't know, depending on where I put it in the video, where people ask. This is going to be a jar, and we'll make the lid and the jar at the same time by making a closed form. So I'm going to center, and I'm going to do my best to center real well. This is some clay that I'm not used to working with. I just got a little bit of this to try out. So it's a little different from the swap clay. It takes a little to feel of it. Pulling up again, just to get it good. Center it down. There was a slight bubble on the side of it when I did that. Okay. I'm going to center down and make space on that. Okay. Oh, let's make this hair wider. But remember, begin with the end in mind. So I'm centering down because I know this is about how big I want the base to be. So I'm going to open up just like a normal cylinder. And this is one of, while you don't have to fit the lid for this, it is a slightly more difficult throwing method. Got it nice and smooth on the bottom. I do like to go back over my finger because I feel like the rib leaves, I don't know, a different texture than my finger, than which would be in the rest of the pot. And slot bottom. Let's pull up a wall. And because we're going to close this in, I want to make sure as I pull up the wall that I'm going towards the center. And just like you do that pretty much with any cylinder, keep it in kind of a volcano shape, because once you start laying it out, it's very hard to get it back in. You can always bring it out later. And another pull. Well, that made it the right thickness all the way up, but a little bit too thick on the bottom, so see if we can get a little of that thickness off the bottom. I was just throwing with the slip that's on my fingers and not adding any water to that on the inside. We're going to continue coloring it in. And we don't want to try to close it up here. We're trying to close it more in here. So we close it up there. When we cut the extra off, we do something else with it. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and just do that. Now, instead of cutting this off down here, I'm going to cut it off up here. Just take off over that excess. And I'm going to use this to make a little knob on the top. Recommend that, or you can use one of these little knives. You can see that X-Acto knife. I think I don't even use my needle because with the knife you have to worry about which side you cut it with. So I'm gonna make cut right through. Right. Woo! There we go. Fell off. Probably got a little ding, but. Okay. Okay, so here's our lid. Now it doesn't quite fit just yet, but we will clean the shrimp up and it will. So we're probably gonna get lots of milk right on the inside of this, but I'm just gonna leave any of these little shreddings up in there because right now it's slightly damp on the inside. They will. If I try to get them up, it'll mess up the bottom and they'll end up sticking to it. If I let them dry, then I can just brush them out. Go ahead. I didn't trim it then, I probably should be using my finger, but whatever. What's done is done. Then we have our lid, and I'm just going to tidy it up a bit with my fingers, smoothing it out. Let's see. Give it a little shimmy sense. There we go. And we have a perfect fit lid. Lid and jar, one throw. Now, like I said, this got a little messy where I cut it off. So I can just take slightly damp finger or a sponge and go back and clean that up. But if I get it damp, I do not want to put it back on this while it's damp. Because it will attach. That would not be good.